you talk a little bit about what is Second Step and what are the resources available to parents right now through the Parent Hub that could help support some of that learning that has happened on social and emotional learning in our schools?
Second Step is our social emotional learning curriculum that we use with pre-K through fifth grade in Leander. And those lessons are taught every week by our teachers, and they are followed up with practice activities. So just like learning to read, it's, you know, they do it a lesson and then you practice and you talk about it some more and you practice. And so they focus on skills like learning to get along with one another, resolving conflicts, learning to manage your emotions, because we know everyone has strong emotions and that is totally okay. But it's what you do with those emotions that's so important, and making sure that we can think clearly and make good decisions. And so those are all the skills that our teachers and our counselors are supporting at school too. So Second Step is the curriculum that we use. And as families, you have access to all of the songs and videos, everything your kids are doing in the classroom, you have access to that at home also. So while your kids may not be getting a direct lesson right now from their teachers, you can go back and watch the videos and the songs that they've used in classroom before that they're familiar with, practice those at home. If you go to the Parent Hub, you just go, there's a link right there. You go to secondstep.org and you just put in the activation code for your grade level, and everything you need will be right there for you. And if you need help with that, please contact your school counselor. They will be more than happy to talk you through any of those questions and support you with that, because those are great resources for families, good ideas that you can use at home also.
What kind of specific skills, other than the ones that we showed, can parents expect if they engage with the Second Step curriculum while we're doing our remote learning?
Just like with academic skills, kids are not born knowing how to join in a game. So our parents do a great job teaching those skills at home, but we want to support that at school too. And so make sure that instead of just saying, well, go make a friend, it breaks down, how do I make a friend? If that doesn't maybe necessarily come natural to me, this is how I can go make a friend. Or if I did miss hearing what the teacher said with instructions, how do I ask for help? Not only do I need to ask for help, but then what are the steps to do that? And even using that word assertively, of just, you know, not standing there and waiting for someone to notice you need help, but saying what you need. And so those are the kinds of skills that we're teaching through the Second Step curriculum, the teachers are and the counselors are doing. And so at home, it's going to break down, what were those steps? So like, how to make a friend, what were the steps? What are the steps when you have a problem? You do this first, and then you do that, and then you do the next thing. And so the parents can be using the same vocabulary at home as we're using at school. And we know there's a lot of power when we're using the same words at home and at school. And so those are things that you can continue to practice at home. And we know those things are coming up at home right now. So now is a great time for you to have access to those resources and listen to those songs as a family. Some of those songs are pretty funny. There's some really good dances that go along with them. So have some fun with it. And again, if you need help with any of that, please let your school counselor know. They'll be happy to help you.